starting in fifth grade, students have the opportunity to play any of the band or orchestra options. So we've got violin, viola, and cello for orchestra. And we've got flute, clarinet, trumpet, and trombone for band. Students do not have to have any prior experience with music or even with instruments. We start students from scratch. We teach them how to hold their instrument, how to play their instrument, and then they're eventually able to play full pieces.
You've got a band of 70 kids in it. There's going to be 70 different ability levels for the whole time. And as long as you are individually getting better, that's what it's all about. And we're all going to grow and get better, you know, from there. Kids in fifth and sixth grade, they get a lesson once a week in their school, where they just come out of a class and they get a lesson with a qualified teacher right there at their building, and they learn how to play their instrument. Then we start an after-school component to our program, where the kids go in bands and orchestras at the junior highs, their local junior highs, where they learn how to play together. So there's the individual, let's learn how to play an instrument for you, and then let's learn how to make this instrument work with everybody else in the bigger programs. And then in junior high, our program really kind of takes a different tact, and it's actually a class where the kids in band and orchestra get to meet every day as a class, as a full band or orchestra. And the strides that we see at that level is really great because the kids are playing every day all together. They still get a lesson once a week in their junior highs.
And it's a really fun learning experience because the more you learn, the better you become. And it's actually a lot easier than people thought. So when I first started, I was like shocked on how much easier it got the more I practiced.
It's different because it's an art, and sometimes an art is more flexible in a way. You can try new things where you're not just gaining information, you can sometimes even teach the person that you're talking to. It's kind of like a creative environment, and you're all just one happy community that is playing music, and it's different because you're not sitting in a classroom. You're able to communicate in a way with creativity.
It makes it unique because you have the chance to work with so many people. For example, one of our after-school rehearsals maybe had 100 kids, and we're all playing and performing together, and every person matters just as much as the next.
Music is crucial. It's unlike any other form, any other class. It allows students to create art and play together as a group, as a family, and you're working together. So it feels like a team, it feels like a family. You come in the room, you have this moment to relax, to make beautiful music, join together as a family, and it's very life-giving for the students.
In fifth and sixth grade, there'll be some opportunities at the grade schools. A lot of times they'll go out caroling around the holiday times. And then with the after-school band and orchestras, they also have one or two big concerts, like at the junior high in the gym, where their parents and grandparents and, you know, and friends can come and see them. And that's always special for that, you know, first big concert that the kids have. In seventh grade, the band and orchestras will have a concert in the fall. They'll have a concert in the spring. They'll usually do some kind of combination program with the high schools that they're at and do a concert there. The seventh graders for band, they usually play at the graduations for the eighth graders and kind of turns them into the eighth grade group. And then in eighth grade, they get all those performances again, but then they add on even more. So our band and orchestra programs in eighth grade, they do Septemberfest in Schaumburg, which is a wonderful event. In band, we add the football game component so they can kind of see what happens if they continue on, hopefully into high school and do that. And then they've got the concerts at the school like they had in seventh grade. And most groups in our district, band and orchestra, try to do some big culminating event at the end of the year too with their eighth graders.
When you join, you automatically get like 60, 70 more friends. You get that companionship. And then, you know, the band directors are really nice. So it's not like if you think they're gonna like pick on you like just because you did a wrong note, that's not what's gonna happen. And then it's always just really fun to play an instrument.
I've learned how to play my instrument, and I've learned how to understand music, but I've also learned how to almost understand people more, because I have to understand how their sound fits with mine, and I have to understand how we can fit together and create a harmony.
They're going to walk out being musicians, they're going to feel empowered, and they're going to feel that they can do this for the rest of their lives.